Our next speaker is Maulana Naseem Mehdi Saab, missionary in charge in Naiv Amir, USA. He's going to talk to us about Zikr-e-Habib, remembrance of Hazrat Aqdas Masih Maud alayhi salam.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين لقد كان لكم في رسول الله أسوة حسنة لمن كان يرجو الله واليوم الآخرة وذكر الله كثيرا. I have just recited verse number 22 of chapter Al-Ahzab, chapter number 33 of the Holy Quran. Allah says, you will find a beautiful example, a beautiful model in the Prophet of Allah. And this model is for those yarjullaha wal yawm al akhirah. They hope to meet Allah, to develop a personal relationship with Him, and also have their reward on the last day. Wa zakar Allah kaseera, and they also remember Allah much. The term Zikr-e-Habib is used in Jamaat-e-Ahmadiyya when we talk about the life and character of Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wassalam. And when we talk about the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, as you all know, the term is Siratul Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam. I have chosen some of the narratives from Siratul Mahdi, compiled by Hazrat Mirza Bashir Ahmed Sahib رضی اللہ تعالی عنہ. And today I'm going to present only those narrations which were mentioned by Hazrat Amma Jan رضی اللہ تعالی عنہ. We call her Amma Jan. He is the mother of the faithful. He was the second wife of Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam. Her name was Hazrat Nusrat Jahan Begum Sahiba. The reason why I'm doing this is that a wife is the closest person to the husband, and she can see the character and the morals of a person. So, because she's so close and she is watching and dealing with that person. As Hazrat Khadija radiallahu ta'ala anha gave her very powerful testimony after the first revelation to Hazrat Rasul Akram sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When Hazrat sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came back from Cave of Hira, he was shivering and he was fearful. He was the most courageous person on earth, but he was afraid of that grand responsibility which Allah has bestowed upon him. So she consoled the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and said that Allah will never ever humiliate you because you have all these different qualities. And she stood firm, and in reality she became the first person to believe in the message given to Hazrat Rasul Akram sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Hazrat Mirza Bashir Ahmad Sahib radhiyallahu ta'ala anhu, when he was compiling these statements, so he naturally asked his mother, Hazrat Amma Jaan radhiyallahu ta'ala anha, to give her testimony, or how he saw how was the life and character of Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam. And it was not just one statement. Whenever she would remember something, and Hazrat Miyan Sahab would write it and record it. And in that Siratul Mahdi, Hazrat Mirza Bashir Ahmad Sahib writes that sometime only one narrative can bring about a revolution in one's life. It is how you feel it, how your state of mind is, and how your spiritual advancement is. Sometimes only by seeing one thing, there is a grand revolution in your life. As some of the bitter enemies of Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam, when they saw him, just by seeing his face, they immediately accepted him and they became saints, and they were the worst worldly people before that. Hazrat Amma Jaan radhiyallahu ta'ala anha says that Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam had the habit of remaining with ablution all the time. Now apparently it is a very simple statement that Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam was always, as we call it, ba-wuzu. Whenever he had to go to the bathroom to respond to the call of nature, he would immediately refresh his wuzu. Apparently it's a very simple statement, but I just want to spend some time, because many of our youngsters, they do not understand the importance of wuzu and ablution. Wuzu is the physical preparation for our worship to God. And if it is not done with intention, many times people say, I have taken the shower, so naturally wuzu is included. It's not. You have to do your wuzu in the very beginning of your bath. And you should know it that you are doing wuzu. It's not, a person is hungry day long. He was busy in his work and he did not eat, he did not take a sip of water. You cannot say that he was fasting. Fasting is only if you have the intention to fast. So remember that whenever you take your daily shower, you should start with wuzu. And the importance of wuzu was highlighted by the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam himself. Once he said, and he was sitting with his Sahaba, and he said water should be brought, and then he did ablution in front of them. He washed his head, he washed his mouth, he washed his nose, his face. Then he washed his both arms to the, to the elbows, and then he washed his feet to the ankles, and did it properly. He said, if a person does this properly, the wuzu which I have performed in front of you, and then offers 2 rakat of nawafil, and between the wuzu and those nawafil, he does not say a word to anybody, all his previous sins are forgiven. It is such a powerful statement. So you see that wuzu can just wash all our sins. And you know, sometimes people wait that when I will have the chance in old age, when I'm retired and I'm getting pension, I will go to Hajj, and then I will seek forgiveness of my sin. Hazrat Rasul Akram sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, it can happen any time. The only thing is your intention, that I will seek forgiveness of Allah, I repent, and I will bring about a change, I will go and just do the ablution, offer 2 rakat, in those rakat I will seek Allah's forgiveness. And the grand news given by the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is that all your previous sins can be forgiven. Hazrat Amma Jaan radiallahu ta'ala anha has confirmed, and that was in reality the sunnah of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that their wuzu was always intact. And at night when they would go to bed, they will also do ablution, and then they would go to bed. Hazrat Usman radiallahu ta'ala anhu, once in his khilafat, he was the 3rd Rashid Khalifa, he did the same thing. He was, you know, he wanted to convey this. He did not relate so many ahadith, and he said, bring water, and then he did wudu, and he said, I'm doing exactly the way Ahadra sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did it, and then he gave this good news to the people. Hazrat Amma Jaan radiallahu ta'ala anha also says that during the day and during the night, and also when Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi wasallam was sleeping and he would change his position, always he would say, Subhanallah wa bihamdihi, Subhanallah al-Azim. And this is a statement taught by the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It's a very well-known hadith that Huzur said, that this is a very simple statement on the tongue. It is very easy to memorize, but the weight in the scale is very high. And once he was asking his Sahaba, can you do 1,000 good deeds in one day? And the Sahaba thought that it was a very difficult thing. How could you do 1,000 good deeds in one day in 24 hours? And they normally responded, Allahu wa Rasuluhu alam, Allah and the Prophet know the best. And then he said, I tell you, if you say 100 times, Subhanallah wa bihamdihi, Subhanallah al-Azim, for every statement, it will be written one good deed. And if you do it 100 times, you can do this in perhaps less than 10 minutes. And if you have done 100 good deeds, the reward will be for 1,000, because every goodness is rewarded 10 times. So how easy Hazrat Rasul Akram sallallahu alaihi wasallam has made for us, and now how beautifully Hazrat Masih Maud alaihi wasallam revived this uswa, this beautiful example of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in this time and age. Hazrat Amma Jaan says that except sickness, Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi wasallam always offered 10 rakat of tahajjud, and even in his last illness, when he could not stand up, he would do it in his bed, but he never left tahajjud all his life. And he would sometime offer 2 or 4 rakat of ishraq. This is a prayer which can be offered when the sun is risen. And our Hazrat sallallahu alaihi wasallam normally would offer ishraq if he has missed tahajjud because of some sickness. And this was also what Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi wasallam did. Somebody asked, how was the night of Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi wasallam? And Hazrat Amma Jaan رضی اللہ تعالیٰ عنہ relates that major portion of the night was spent by Hazrat Masih Maud Salatu Wasalam in the writing of books. Major portion of the night. And then because he also suffered, he was diabetic and he had to go to the washroom again and again. So his sleep was disturbed because of this also, and then he would get up for tahajjud. His real sleep was after Fajr prayer. And that was the time he would take rest before he would go to his morning walk. Hazrat Mirza Bashir Ahmed Sahib has added a footnote here, and he said, Hazur did not like kerosene oil lamp. He would like the candles, and he would burn, you know, many candles at a time so that there is enough light, and then he would continue his writing. And it is also recorded that he would not sit on a table. It's very strange. He would write while he was walking. Hazrat Mauli Ata Muhammad Sahib was a Sahabi of Hazrat Masih Maud Alaihi Salatu Wasalam, and I was in Jamia. He was a teacher. He was teacher of Urdu and specialized how to teach Urdu to foreigners. And he was a Sahabi, father of Maulana Naseem Saifi Sahib. I asked him, I said, tell me something about Hazrat Masih Maud Alaihi Salatu Wasalam. And he mentioned this, that in a small room I saw that Hazrat Masih Maud Alaihi Salatu Wasalam was walking, and he had a paper like this and keep on writing, and there were two pots of ink on both sides, and he would use a nib with a holder. He would take the ink and keep on writing and then go to the other side, and all day long, and he would not sit on the table. And you know, so there are people who can say, we cannot work because we don't have a proper table and all this. Hazrat Masih Maud Alaihi Salatu Wasalam wrote 80 books without all these different facilities. Hazrat Amma Jaan رضی اللہ تعالیٰ عنہ says, and I will not repeat again and again, all these points are taken from his narratives, that Huzoor would offer sunnah prayers at home, and farz will be offered in the mosque, and that was his routine, and that was also following the sunnah of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And then the question was asked that how was his prayer. He said that the prayer will be light and not very long, because he would offer sunnah, go to the mosque, and then come back and offer if the prayer were that prayer where the sunnah was also offered afterwards. Hazrat Amma Jaan relates that one day we were with Hazrat Masih Maud Alaihi Salatu Wasalam, and the children were also with us. And apart from this, we find many other narrations where the children would go to Hazrat Masih Maud Alaihi Salatu Wasalam again and again. It is recorded that Hazrat Khalifat Masih Sani رضی اللہ تعالیٰ عنہ, when he was a little kid, he would go and ask, Father, give me something, and he would use the Punjabi word chitti. Chitti means something white, so it means he was interested to have something sweet, and Hazrat Masih Maud Alaihi Salam would take a little bit sugar, put his in mouth, and he will go away and will start writing, and then he will come sometime 10 times, sometime 20 times, and he will always do that and never say that, don't bother me. So Hazrat Amma Jaan has not mentioned the name because she said, I have forgotten who he was. But Hazrat Al-Muslim Maud رضی اللہ تعالیٰ says that I was the person, we were in a garden, there were orange trees, there was no fruit, this was not the season of oranges. And then I said, Abba, I want an orange. And Hazrat Masih Maud رضی اللہ تعالیٰ said, you want orange? And he said, yes. Hazrat Amma Jaan says that I saw Hazrat Masih Maud Alaihi Salaam raise his hand towards the tree and then gave him that orange. And there was no fruit on the trees, and it was not the season. And Hazrat Musa Maud radiallahu ta'ala anhu confirmed that he was the one who requested that. She mentions that Hazrat Musa Maud radiallahu ta'ala told me that I was coming from Amritsar, and I wanted to take a yakka, this horse-driven, you know, buggy or whatever. And there was also a Hindu businessman, and he knew that it was sun was shining, it was very hot day, and he knew that on this side there'll be continuously there'll be sun, and it will be, so he took the seat on the other side so that he's in the shade. And Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam came and sat with him in the sun. So it started. And Hazur said, when we started, immediately a very small cloud came and covered the sun till our journey to Qadian. And Hazur said that it became so visible that Hindu came and he apologized, and he said, I'm very sorry, I should have not done it, I was very selfish, but I have seen this miracle, how God has treated you. She mentions that Huzur told us that once he was going to Dalhousie with a couple of his disciples for a court case. And it started raining very heavily. And they could not continue. And they were also in a tanga, in that buggy. And then they decided to stop. So Huzur remained behind, and they went and they knocked at the door of a person. And this was a lone house. And they knocked at the door, and a person came out. And Huzur said that he started hearing that person has started abusing them and shouting and etc., etc. Huzur said, and I went and stood in front of him. When he saw me, he immediately said, please come in. And he was at peace. And when Huzur entered his house, he was very much embarrassed that why did I do it. But after seeing the face of the Holy Azam Srimad alayhi salatu wasalam, he was satisfied. And he said, the reason is that this is a house, this is alone, we are alone here, and not a lot of people around us, and I have a young daughter, and I did not want to take a chance that I should let the strangers come in, but when I saw your face, I realized that it is okay, and there was no problem. Once Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam went for a court hearing, and he was waiting outside under the shade of a tree. And you know, the people were going one by one, and they were making the announcement. And then the time of prayer came, and this is very important for our daily routine. Sometime we are in a hurry, we want to go for shopping, or somebody is waiting, and we try to offer our prayer quickly so that we can go. And this is not an important matter, or more important than worship. There could be nothing more important than worship. But sometime, even for minor things, we try to, you know, finish our prayer quickly because we had to go somewhere. When Huzur said Allahu Akbar and started the prayer, and they started calling his name, that now the turn of your case is, and you come in, and Huzur continued his prayer, and peacefully he finished his prayer. When he finished the prayer, the clerk of that court was standing beside him, and he said, Mirza Sahab, Mubarak ho, congratulations, you won your case. So that was his, resignation to the will of Allah, that now I am worshipping him and I don't care about these worldly matters. It is in the hands of Allah, and Allah will take care of me. Hazrat Amma Jaan رضی اللہ تعالی mentions that when Huzoor was healthy and there was no sickness, he would complete his fasting in the month of Ramadan, and he would never miss the six rozas or fasting of Shawwal. Always he would fast those 6 days. And she also mentions that when in the later part of his life, he would immediately, when the Ramadan will come, he will be excited and he will start fasting, but after a few days he will fall ill, and then he would give up and would give fidya. And then everybody say that next year you should not, but next year he would do it again, because he was excited when the month of Ramadan came. And when sometime he would pass out because of that fasting, and I suspect because he was diabetic and he would go for a long morning walk, it must be hypoglycemia, that his sugar level would go down. And fasting in that was perhaps the reason. But anyhow, and Hazrat Amma Jaan also said that whenever there was a special need or something special that he was going to offer prayers, he would have an optional fast. It was asked that, have you seen Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam when he was receiving revelation? And she said, yes, his face will be red, and you would see the sweating on his forehead, and he would have a slight slumber, and then he would wake up and mention that I have received this revelation. And normally he would write in a notebook. In the earlier time he was not very careful, but when there were so many revelations coming, so he used to keep a notebook all the time and he would note it. We also find this by the Sahaba of Ahadrat Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, that Ahadrat Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam also had this kind of feeling when he received the revelation. And Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha says that sometime it was the cold weather, but when he would receive the revelation, I could see the sweating on his forehead. Hazrat Amma Jaan radiallahu ta'ala anha says that Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam would give sadaqah much, and almost on daily basis. And he wanted that some money should be taken out of the usual household expenses. Money should be separated for sadaqah. So whenever he would receive, she said that at least 10% would be separated. And Hazur used to say that if you don't do it, the money is spent and then you don't do or you don't give sadaqah. And the question was asked that whether it was he would make any distinction between Ahmadis and non-Ahmadis, and she said no, whether somebody was a non-Muslim, if he or she was needy, he would give it. He also had this revival of the Sunnah of the Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. If he would borrow money, when he was paying back, he would give a little more. And if somebody has borrowed money from him, many a time he would say that don't worry about it and keep it. And once Hazrat Khalifatul Masih Awwal borrowed some money and he gave it back, and Hazur didn't like it. Hazur said, no, I and you are one, and why are you making this that you have to give me that money back? Hazrat Amma Jaan رضی اللہ تعالیٰ relates that when there was no langar khana, and for a very long time there was no langar khana, food for all the people, all the visitors were prepared at home. And this was a big task. And when the langar khana started, Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam kept langar khana as a supervision in his own control. And he was always worried that some guest might not be neglected. And sometime at night, he would take someone Somebody is having a lamp in front of him, and he has some milk, and he said, I knew that you have the habit of drinking milk at night, so I have brought this milk for you. And he would take care of all his guests all the time. Hazrat Ammajan says that especially on Friday he would use perfume, and this was also the sunnah of the Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. So you know, whenever we use perfume, if we just for a moment say that Hazrat Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam has asked us to use perfume when we go out, even using perfume become a good act. And as Hazur Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam especially used perfume on Fridays, he did the same thing. So my brothers and sisters, the purpose of these narratives is that we should ponder, we should learn lessons, we should try to improve ourselves. And Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam had this responsibility given by Allah that he would revive the faith, he would establish the Sharia. And this was not just writing books, it was by producing a community, preparing a community who would act like the Sahaba of Hazrat sallallahu alayhi wasalam, who would revive the beautiful example of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam in their lives, so that they can tell people, if you want to come and see a community who is following that model of Hazrat Rasul Akram sallallahu alayhi wasallam, come to us, come to our community, or for that matter, come to any Ahmadi home, and you will see it, and you will know that this grand task has been done by the Promised Messiah alayhi wasallam, and a continuous system of Khilafat has been established, which will never end till the end of time, till the day of judgment. So may Allah bless us all, and may Allah enable us that we should become grateful servants of God in the real sense of the word, and we do our responsibility, because it is not just by talk, it is not by making statements and beautiful speeches, it is by bringing about a revolution, a positive revolution in our life. May Allah bless us all.
Jazakumullah wa sallam.